Hey, what's up guys? I am back in the kitchen today wearing my lab jacket, and you know what that means. We are about to do something extremely dangerous. Now I have over here some very, very concentrated bottles of sulfuric and nitric acids. These things are extremely, extremely dangerous substances. I also have some baking soda, some cotton balls, and some tampons. You'll see what those are for later. Now for this experiment today, I thought it might be fun to try making nitro cotton, or gun cotton, flash cotton, whatever you want to call it. It goes by a lot of different names. Now whatever you want to call this stuff, the process of making it isn't very difficult at all. Very, very dangerous, but not difficult. Let me show you what I mean. Now to make this experiment a little more scientific, we are going to be measuring our results. I have a little scientific beaker here, so we can measure out equal portions of sulfuric and nitric acid. Then we're going to dip them one by one, letting them each soak in the solution for about 5 minutes, take them out, rinse them, let them dry, and measure the results. Now the sulfuric acid I'm using is 93% sulfuric acid. I got this stuff from a chemical supply store, and I'm using it just for convenience. We could use the sulfuric acid I extracted from my car battery in a previous video, but for this experiment here, I want the results to be as pure as we can get them. We're also using 70% nitric acid, which we could make ourselves. However, the time and effort that would need to go into producing it is beyond the scope of our experiment today. Now my beaker measures up to 120 milliliters, and I want to do a 50-50 ratio of sulfuric and nitric acid. So let's start off filling our beaker with 60 milliliters of nitric acid first, then follow it up with 60 milliliters of sulfuric acid to top it off. Now because we're dealing with some pretty dangerous chemicals here, I have a bag of ice and some baking soda. The idea being that we can fill up a bowl with ice water, so if we have a thermal runaway, we have a place to dump it, and mix with baking soda so we have a solution that'll help neutralize any acid if we have any accidental spills. Okay, so our nitric and sulfuric acids have been mixed, and it's very important to know that when these two liquids mix together, they heat up very fast. Using an infrared thermometer, we can see this liquid goes from about 68 degrees Fahrenheit up to 120 degrees Fahrenheit in just a few seconds. That's a difference of around 20 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius for our international viewers. And that is one of the reasons we have our bath of ice standing by. Oh, and by the way, the fumes are toxic. Now this is actually still quite warm, and we need it to cool back down to room temperature. So while we're waiting, let's weigh out our cotton balls. Now I'm not exactly sure how much cotton our 120 milliliter solution of acid can handle. So I'm gonna weigh out and track 8 different cotton balls so we can measure their success after they've been nitrated, so we can find the point where the nitration starts dropping off. Here goes cotton ball number 1. And it looks like we are at 0.55 grams. Cotton ball number 2. 0.60. Number 5. Now at the beginning of this video I told you we might be doing something with tampons as well, and here's what I'm thinking. If we open up one of these applicator packages and take a look inside, you can see the tampon is mostly just made of cotton. So if we stripped away the outer membrane and dipped just the cotton tampon into our solution, do you think it would be possible to get a tampon to work as well? Flash Tampax? That doesn't really serve any useful purpose, it's just for fun. 2.4. So our solution has cooled down to about 85 degrees Fahrenheit. That's good enough for me. So let's go ahead and take cotton ball number 1 and use a glass stir stick to hold it in solution so it can nitrate for about 5 minutes. Now that the cotton is nitrating, theoretically the temperature should be rising again as well. You can see we're already up to 88 Fahrenheit. Now while our cotton ball is soaking here, let me tell you a little bit about what's taking place. The fibers of the cotton ball themselves are reacting with the nitric acid to nitrate the cotton, which also releases moisture into the solution. Now moisture isn't really good for this reaction, so the sulfuric acid, which is a dehydrating agent, absorbs that moisture and keeps the reaction relatively clean. Depending on how much cotton we have in the solution, the reaction can get very, very hot, which is why we're measuring the temperature and we have a bath of ice water we can dump it to if we need to. All right, good news, it's been 5 minutes, so our time is up with cotton ball number 1. So we're just gonna fish that off, and we're gonna squeeze it to leave as much of the liquid as we can in the container, and we're gonna transfer it to a glass of fresh water and let it soak. You can see that as we dab the cotton ball into the water, it releases quite a bit of the acid that it has stored, and we need to do this 4 to 7 times to thoroughly rinse out as much acid as we can possibly get. Let's see if there's any fizzing. There's a little bit of acid on there. The baking soda helps neutralize any of the leftover acid in the cotton. Now we simply repeat that process over and over again until all 8 cotton balls are finished. Update, guys, all 8 of our cotton balls are finished. They have been fully nitrated, they've been washed, rinsed, cleansed, and put on this plate to sit overnight to dry. Unfortunately, while they're still wet, we don't have any way to test them, but in tomorrow's video, we're gonna light them off and see how they perform. And what's gonna happen with this thing? Could it be that we've just invented the world's first pyrotechnic tampon? I'm very curious to find out. So in the meantime, let's take just a second to briefly recap what we did here today and what we're trying to accomplish. We start off our experiment with sulfuric and nitric acid and the intent to mix them together in a 50-50 ratio. But going back and looking at it, I think I messed up things being from this angle and added 80 milliliters of nitric acid and 60 milliliters of sulfuric acid. But I think it's still gonna work out. Next, we weighed and documented each of our cotton balls and then soaked them one by one in the solution for 5 minutes. After soaking for 5 minutes, we squeezed all the acid out of them, rinsed them 4 different times, and then put them in a solution of baking soda to neutralize any leftover acid. After that, they were rinsed one more time and then all the water was squeezed out. Then they were placed on this plate where they could sit overnight to dry. So here's the question I want to figure out tomorrow. How much cotton does it take to use up all the nitric acid in our solution? Tomorrow we're going to play with these cotton balls to see if they go off with a flash, and we're going to burn through each of them to see where the nitration point started to drop off. How many of these cotton balls do you think were successfully transferred into flash cotton? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. Well, that's it for today. All we can do now is wait. Thanks for joining me for this video. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. Whoa. That's cool. Sweet. That was a little more vigorous than I was expecting. Hey guys, thanks for watching, and remember, I'm giving away prizes now on every new video. All you have to do to qualify is subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and select to be notified when my next videos get released. The secret link to my giveaways will be pinned in the comments for the first 12 hours. If you like what I'm doing, show your support right now by giving this video a big thumbs up and share with a friend. I love you back, and I'll see you next time.